بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whosoever Allah guides, none can mislead. And so whosoever Allah misleads, none can guide. Abara, a witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah. And Abara, a witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his last messenger. May Allah's peace and blessing be upon him. Dear viewers, welcome to the best of knowledge. The scholars have said that the best of knowledge is the knowledge that will enable you to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. The best of knowledge is the knowledge that will make you fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and heedful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by knowing His attributes. And in this series, we'll be talking about the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the madness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the life of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in each episode, we'll be talking about one of Allah's exalted attributes. And we will ponder upon its impact on our lives. And we will see how we should conduct ourselves in light of this attribute by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, we'll be talking about the richness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala is the most rich. Allah ta'ala is the richest. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran described Himself saying, وَرَبُّكَ الْغَنِيُّ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ. And your Lord is the most rich, the all rich. Allah ta'ala is the richest, the one who is full of mercy, ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ, the one who is full of pity, تَبَارَكَ وَتَقَدَّسِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the richest. Everything in this universe actually belongs to Him. Everything belongs to Him. Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Don't you know that Allah ta'ala has the kingship of the heaven and the earth? وَمَا لَكُمْ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مِن وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ. And you don't have beside Allah Ta'ala any helper or protector or defender. Everything belongs to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Everything in this universe is part of Allah's kingdom and belongs to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Even our properties and our wealth belongs to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. He is the richest. Everything belongs to Him. We might own something, but you only own it for a short period. As for Allah Ta'ala, He owns everything eternally. He owns us. We are part of His kingdom. He owns us and He owns all of our wealth. Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala in the Quran said, إِن كُلُّ مَن فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا آتِ الرَّحْمَنِ عَبْدًا. Everyone in the heaven and everyone on the earth will come to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala as a slave. So Allah Ta'ala owns everything in this life and He owns all of our money and all of our properties. And we only hold it for a short period. And that's why when He spoke to us about donating for His sake, He said, تَبَارَكَ وَتَقَدَّسْ وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا جَعَلَكُمْ مُسْتَخْلَفِينَ فِيهِ. And give in the sake of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala from that money which Allah Ta'ala has made you entrusted upon. He didn't say your money because you don't own it. You only own it for a short period. And Allah Ta'ala will see how you'll act with it. And Allah Ta'ala owns it eternally. So Allah Ta'ala said, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا جَعَلَكُمْ مُسْتَخْلَفِينَ فِيهِ. So spend from that which you are entrusted upon. You don't own it. Allah owns it. Allah owns everything. Allah owns even yourself and your property and your wealth. Allah is the richest. And that's why Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ O people, أَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ إِلَى اللَّهِ You are the poor in your relationship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ And Allah is the richest. Allah is the all rich. Allah ta'ala is the rich. And He is the only absolute. Allah owns everything. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a sound hadith said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so generous. His hand is so generous. And he said that his hand is full of bounties and full of pleasures and full of provisions. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said that haven't you seen what he has spent since he has created the heavens and the earth, all what he has given to his slaves and to his creations did not decrease any of his wealth. All what he has given to us did not decrease anything of his wealth. Did not decrease anything which is in his hand. Subhanallah. Glory be to Allah. He is the all rich and he is the richest. Although he's given us, but his rich and his wealth will not decrease. Subhanallah. Furthermore, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the sound hadith Sahih al-Bukhari said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Qudsi hadith said, Ya ibadi law anna awwalakum, Ya ibadi law anna awwalakum wa akhirakum qamu fi sa'idin wahid, fasa'alani kullu wahidin minkum mas'alatahu. O my slaves, if all of you were to stand together, were to stand together or to stand up together in one place, all of you from Adam alayhi salam to the last soul on this earth, if all of you were to stand together and to come together, and every one of you asks me whatever he desires, and I fulfilled for him whatever he desires, and I gave him whatever he wants, all of that will not decrease an atom of my kingdom. Subhanallah. All of our desires, whatever we want from Allah Ta'ala, will not decrease anything from His kingdom. But Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala sometimes might narrow our provision. Because if Allah Ta'ala expand our provision sometimes, we might transgress. We might forget Him. We might be disobedient towards Him. And that's why Allah Ta'ala said, وَلَوْ بَسَطَ اللَّهُ الرِّزْقَ لِعِبَادِهِ لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ And if Allah Ta'ala extended and expanded His provision for His slaves on earth, they will cause corruption. They will be heedful, they will be heedless about Him. They will forget Him. And that's why Allah Ta'ala will descend that which is with measure. Allah Ta'ala will give us with measure. But Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala also is the rich and the most generous. And Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, Ya ayyuhal insan, O man, ما غرك بربك الكريم. What has made you careless about your Lord, who is the most generous? اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق. And then Allah Ta'ala said, اقرأ وربك الأكرم. Read. And Allah Ta'ala is the most generous. Allah Ta'ala is the most generous. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the sound hadith said that Allah Ta'ala is Jawad. He is the best of those. He is the best bestower. And He is the most generous. And He loves people to be generous. Tabaraka wa taqaddas. So, how shall we conduct ourselves in light of this attribute? First of all, we should ask Allah Ta'ala alone. We should not ask anyone else beside Him. Because Allah Ta'ala is the rich. And Allah Ta'ala is the richest. And whatever He gives to us will not decrease any of His wealth. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to Ibn Abbas, he said to him, O young man, be mindful of Allah, and Allah Ta'ala will protect you. Be mindful of Allah, and Allah Ta'ala will be there for you. If you ask, then ask Allah Ta'ala alone. If you seek help, then seek it from Allah Ta'ala alone. Ask Allah Ta'ala alone. He is the one who will help you and give you from His wealth. Furthermore, when you ask Allah Ta'ala, ask Him, or begin asking Him with praising Him. Praise Allah Ta'ala. Praise Him and then thank Him. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ, thank Him for His favors upon you. لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ, if you are thankful, I will give you more. I will expand your wealth. So thank Him secondly. Also, when you ask Allah Ta'ala, be determined. Say, oh Allah Ta'ala, give me. Oh Allah Ta'ala, bestow your mercy upon me. Oh Allah Ta'ala, give me such and such. So be determined. And that's why Nabi Sallam said, أُدْعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَنْتُمْ مُوْقِنُونَ بِالْإِجَابَةِ. Ask Allah Ta'ala with certainty. Ask Allah Ta'ala with certainty. Be certain. Don't be heedless. Because Allah Ta'ala will never accept any dua from or any supplication from inattentive heart. So be certain when you ask Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. And be determined. Say, Allah Ta'ala, give me. But don't say, inshallah, in your dua. Just ask Allah Ta'ala. Allah Ta'ala will give you. Because He is the most rich. And also, when you ask Allah Ta'ala, ask Him anything that you want. And before you ask Him, repent to Him. Because you want to open a new page with Him first. Repent to Him, then ask Him. And look at Sulaiman alayhi salam. The Nabi of Allah, Sulaiman, when he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did he say? He said, قَالَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي, O Allah, forgive me. وَهَبْ لِي مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي, and give me a kingship that is not supposed to be given to anyone after me. Allah Ta'ala gave him that kingship. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَابُ, O Allah, you are the most generous. And Allah Ta'ala gave him a kingship that is not supposed to be given to any one of his creations on this land, on earth. So ask Allah Ta'ala in this manner and adhere to the manners of dua, and I ask Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala to increase our knowledge and to increase our iman and to make us close or to help us to worship Him as He likes Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, and to depend upon Him and to put our trust upon Him and to ask Him alone and not to seek any help from anyone else. May Allah bless you and may Allah reward you, and I will see you soon inshallah ta'ala on the best of knowledge. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.